Hey, what's up Blender users, I'm Jonathan, and this video is again about photogrammetry. About 2 months ago, I showed you my process behind creating a simple model using Capturing Reality. But in hindsight, this process was pretty unintuitive and time-consuming. So in an impulse decision, I grabbed my phone and just took a few pictures of the nearest bookshelf I could find to try photogrammetry again in a more simple way. The lighting wasn't optimal and the pictures were a bit blurry, but in the end it somehow worked. So with that said, let me show you the process and scene setup behind this render. Oh, and by the way, if you enjoy my content, consider subscribing because I upload a new video every Saturday. Of course, we'll start in Capturing Reality to create our model. You can use Capturing Reality for free, but the export function costs money. Luckily, because I'll only use 16 pictures, the dataset only costs me 50 cents. So let's go ahead and drag all of these pictures in here. Because all these images were shot with a smartphone, Capturing Reality will give you a small error right here. But this is fine, we can just start with the alignment. Luckily, Capturing Reality is pretty fast when it comes to alignment and mesh reconstruction, so this will only take a few seconds. And you can already see that our books are correctly displayed in the point cloud. Now in the Reconstruction tab, I'll reconstruct the mesh in normal detail. Now you can see that the books have been reconstructed perfectly, and now it is about texturing. So let's go ahead and click on colorize, and after that texture. And the whole creation of this model now took me about 4 minutes. So this really is a fast workflow. But of course, creating the model is only a small part. We still have to create a final render. So I'll now just export this model and show you an example of how we can use this to create a render. Over in Blender, I'll append this model from another blend file because this one is already decimated and cleaned up by me. For this scene, cleanupping just meant that I'll delete all the outer not needed parts, because all of this geometry would just slow down your viewport. Now the textures are applied, but right now only consist of a diffuse texture. You could of course just leave it there, and for books this might actually work pretty well, but for more control over your texture setup, we could feed the texture into the roughness input, as well as into the normal by using a bump node. Okay, so let's add in a camera, and after that work on the lighting. For this, I'll switch over to Cycles, and in the Shader Editor, over in the World tab, add in an environment texture. I have this indoor one, so let's select it and click on Open Image. Now, with Node Wrangler enabled, we can just select both of these nodes, and with F, connect these two. Now you can see that we have standard lighting in our scene. Right now, the bump map is too noticeable for me, so I'll just turn it down. And also with the camera selected, distance pick a point on our bookshelf and enable depth of field. You can adjust the depth of your scene by sliding around the f-stop slider. And for scenes like this, I like to use a pretty low value just because I personally really enjoy depth blurring. Okay, great, but how can we make this scene even better looking? Well, we could for one add in a volume. So let's add in a cube and scale it up, so it includes everything just like a domain. And then add in a principled volume node. Plug it into the volume input and turn down the density to a pretty low value. Now a gray volume isn't that particularly interesting, so let's for example choose a blue one. This already makes the scene feel a bit more moody. Now, we can make the lighting even better by adding in some area lights on top of the HDRI. For the placement of these lights, we can quickly hide the volume and move them to a place where we want. I want this one to be a lot bigger and have an orange tint. We can now go back into the camera and with the light selected, press W or right click, it depends on with which mouse button you select with. And choosing power, we can adjust the strength of the light to a point where we have a nice orange tint in our scene. This will now create a good contrast to our blue volume. The power is still too low for me, so I'll just set it to about 1500, but still the orange light isn't really visible. We can easily change that by dimming our HDRI. So let's set the background strength to maybe 0.5 or even lower. This of course makes our overall scene darker, but the orange tint comes through a lot better. Now we can of course just duplicate this light and rotate it and maybe give it a darker red. This just makes our scene a lot more interesting. This right here is of course only one example on how you can use photoscanned assets. We could of course also isolate the books and use them for example in a whole library render. But this of course is completely up to you. Hopefully, this video showed that photogrammetry is actually pretty simple, and you don't need expensive gear or good lighting to create your first models. Hopefully, this video was helpful to you. If it was, consider liking and subscribing, and we'll see us in the next video next Saturday.